Tom, welcome to Swansea City and thanks for joining us on SwansTV in the very nice settings of Penny Hill Park here. How have you found your introduction to life with Swansea City and how have things gone so far this week?
Yeah, no, thank you. I really appreciate that. I think very settled quickly. I think everyone at the club, including Julian, the board, Josh, Russell and the direct staff have been very welcoming. I've been very friendly and delighted to be here and I'm really looking forward to getting going.
Yeah, and you're speaking to us today, there's some team building exercises this morning which I think all the staff got involved in. How was that? It was pretty competitive. There were rumours of cheating.
not from our team. Very, very competitive as you can imagine with the boys and the staff and a good piece to bring them all together. And although we're a close group anyway between players and staff, I think that really helps kind of push that on even further. And no, look, it was an enjoyable morning in the heat with the facilities here at Penny Hill Park. And it was a great experience for the players.
Yeah, Tom, you've joined us in the role of head of performance. So supporters will know that Matt Wilmot is obviously the head of physical performance. So just to sort of explain to supporters, could you sort of outline your role with the club and how it dovetails with staff like Matt, for example?
Yeah, good question. And I think the reason why that is probably the case is that the role of head of performance is different across many clubs. And essentially Matt and his arm and area kind of falls under the umbrella or bigger umbrella of performance. And his role day to day is to lead the physical development or physical conditioning, if you like, with the other staff on a day-to-day operation. I guess my role is to strategically lead the performance function of the club, and that includes physical performance or sports science, sports medicine, nutrition, psychology, ensuring that elite high performance development is delivered through an effective framework and performance strategy across both the first team and the academy. And I think the big thing for us going forward is just getting that consistency and stability of performance support across the club from first team to the academy. So yeah, I think that is often the reason why is that the role of head of performance looks different at different clubs. Yeah. But my role essentially is to be that hub in the middle of a wheel with different spokes. Stitching everything together.
Yeah, I mean, how important is that alignment of all the different elements? So we talk about the way we play, the Swansea way of playing, and wanting that pathway to be clear from academy to first team. But to play that way, the performance, sports science element, that's got to be consistent too to match with it, doesn't it?
Exactly, and that was a big factor in me joining the club in that when I met with Julian and the senior hierarchy, that there was a clear philosophy, a clear identity, a clear vision, how we want to build the club, how we want to develop players, and I think it's so important that we have the right performance strategy in place and framework to ensure that happens and you get this consistency and stability throughout and ultimately pushing players through the academy onto the first team.
Yeah, and for supporters who might not know your background too well, Tom, you've been with Nottingham Forest, had spells with Coventry and with Tottenham, but particularly I was interested in your spells with Brighton and Manchester City, clubs that are known for that joined up approach from top to bottom. And Brighton, you were with them from League One to the Premier League.
Exactly, and I've had some wonderful experiences for all the clubs I've been at, notably Brighton, where I spent a long period of my career, as well as Man City. And like you said, I was very fortunate to join Brighton in those early days back in League One, where it took a big collaborative piece with all the arms of the business to kind of get us to the Premier League. And yeah, what a journey to get up there. And obviously you can see now how they're flourishing under Graham, previous yeah. manager here. Another clear identity and clear philosophy. Man City was another great piece of my jigsaw where I learnt a lot from the academy and the first team. I spent time under both kind of structures, and a wonderful place to work, and with the members of staff there. So I know two brilliant clubs to work for.
Yeah, you just said off camera, you feel there are similarities with Swansea to what you found at Brighton?
1,000,000%. I've definitely felt similarities when joining the club, and how I've been received and welcomed, the atmosphere, the environment, the culture. I've felt very, very similar, that friendly, family orientated kind of feel at the club, the support base, which is obviously fantastic. And yeah, really, really positive, and I've had nothing but good feelings since I've joined the club.
You know, during your career, Tom, you've worked, you know, as you said, at a number of clubs, but under a number of different managers and coaches, different tactical philosophies. You know, how much have you taken from that variety, if you like, that, you know, it just gives you so much more information to draw on in any new surroundings, I guess.
Yeah, exactly. I think I've been very fortunate, like you say, to work with a variety of different styles, different philosophies. I think that the key for us as performance staff, as always, is to have that adaptability. Now, I always say to the staff, to the performance staff, that our main purpose and responsibility is to ensure that all the players are available, they're in the optimum condition to deliver the physical demands of the tactical strategy, or the head coach's tactical strategy, in order to win consistently. So I think you have to have an understanding as performance staff as how your program molds around, you know, Russ's tactical demands and the integration of that, and that is key. Again, like you said, been fortunate to work at Man City and Brighton, where, you know, there is an understanding of the adaptability of the performance department around the philosophy and style of the head coach.
Can I sort of ask you what your impressions of Swansea from afar would have been, if you like, Tom? I mean, obviously the club's, you know, had quite a journey over the last 10, 15 years, and I'm sure you'd be aware of it. You know, what have you sort of made from the outside looking in, if you like?
Yeah, I mean, I must admit, apart from the long journey getting here, I've always been hugely impressed with the support, the fan base, the infrastructure. I think another big part of me wanting to join the club was, it's historically been known for giving young people a chance, you know, and that means giving staff a chance and players. If you look back on the eras of obviously Barnden and Roberto and Laudrup, you know, that was clear, and the identity and the brand of the football has played a massive part in Swansea's history. So yeah, no, it's been, the area's been fantastic, I've really enjoyed my time here so far.
Yeah, this is quite an open-ended question, probably a difficult one to answer so soon into the job, but, you know, what are your sort of short-term goals as you come in initially, and then what are you looking to build for the longer term in terms of that structure you spoke
yeah,
about?
Yeah, good question. I think my short-term goals have got to be around building relationships, getting to know people, listening and understanding, running a kind of a needs analysis, looking at kind of previous structure of the department, and then adapting to any kind of things that need to be delivered in the short term. And then long term, I think you're exactly right with what you've already said. I think it's putting a structure in plan, and that's across the club from the first team to the academy. And just having that continuity and consistency in our delivery.
Well, we wish you every success with it, Tom, and thanks again for joining us.
Thank you.